Good evening, friends. I welcome you all in yet another series of GST Easy. Friends, in this video we will learn how to file GSTR 3B online on GST portal. Friends, earlier we had to file GSTR 3B only for the month of July and August, but recently government has made it mandatory to file GSTR 3B for next 4 months also. That means we will have to file GSTR 3B for July, August, September, October, November and till December. Reason being, government has extended the written filing dates of GSTR 1, 2 and 3, and government required some data from SSC. That's why it has extended the filing of GSTR 3B to other months also. So let's move and understand how to file 3B. As you can see, I have already logged in on GST portal. I'll click on Return Dashboard. After Return Dashboard, it will show the financial year and return filing period. We'll learn how to file August month return. I click on Search. As you can see, first is 1 GSTR 1, second is GSTR 2, and third is GSTR 2A, and fourth item is GSTR 3B. Due date is 20th of September for the month of August. I have clicked on Prepare Online. First item is GSTIN of SSC, then its legal name, afterwards status. Then financial year is 2017-18 in our case. Return period is August and the due date is 20th of September. Now move on other blocks that we need to fill. Friends, in GSTR 3B, we don't need to punch individual invoices. Rather, we will have to feed data under various headings. Our first block is tax on outward and reverse charge inward supplies. Let's see what details require there. First item is outward taxable supplies other than zero rated, nil rated and exempt. That means, friend, here you'd need to mention all your supplies, say it's interstate or intrastate, except zero rated, nil rated and exempt. But before I move further, you should know that what is zero rated, nil rated and exempt. Our zero rated supplies are mostly our supplies for purpose of export or supply to SEZ unit, whereas nil rated and exempted goods are goods on which government has made GST rate at nil or has exempted them fully. What is the basic difference between zero rate and nil rate? In case of zero rated, you can take credit of GST paid off inputs, whereas in case of nil rated, you cannot get any credit because the ultimate product or ultimate supply, there is no taxation. Examples of nil rate and exempted goods are fish, milk, curd and various other items that have been notified by government or have been specified in the act. Let's understand how to fill it. First is outward taxable supply. Let's say in our case it's 1 lakh and our item falls under 12% head. Let's say 12,000. Suppose we had some interest local supplies as well. Then let's say we had local supplies as well. Let's say 6,000 and 6,000 SGST. Friends, as you can see, I punched the total taxable value, but there was not auto feeding of IGST, CGST and SGST. Reason being, in case of GSTR 1 and 2, we were feeding respective invoices. We were mentioning what is the GSTR of a particular SSC. That's why system was taking values automatically. But here we have accumulated our value of interstate sale and intrastate sale. That's why we will have to fill the required values. In our case, it's 1 lakh taxable value, and IGST 12,000, CGST 6,000, SGST 6,000. Next is outward taxable supplies zero rate. That means our export supplies, our supplies to SEZ. Let's say it's 5,000 rupees. Let's say IGST. Here, in case of zero rated supply, you have the option either to pay a full tax and apply for refund, or you can opt for not paying any taxes and go for supplying with undertaking. Let's say you have opted for paying taxes and then apply for refund. Next item is other outward supply, that is nil rated and exempted. That means the items on which government has made tax rate nil. You can clearly see there is only taxable value column is in. There is no IGST, no CGST, SGST and CES. That means no credits and no taxes are available on same. Let's say in our case we are supplying 2000 rupees nil rated supply. Next line item is inward supplies liable to reversal. Friends, there are two provisions which deal with reverse charge transactions. First is section 9.3 and second is section 9.4. 9.3 specified certain categories, rather certain transactions which comes under reverse charge permit. These transactions or SSEs are, suppose in case of GTA service, that is Goods Transport Agency service, Insurance Agency service, Recovery Agency service, in these cases the supplier of services will not charge any GST. Rather, it will be duty of recipient to charge, rather to calculate GST and deposit same. In this case, supplier will not be under any kind of obligation to charge and deposit GST. Recipient will be under obligation to deposit GST. If this is the case, this transaction will come under reverse charge. Section 9.4 talks about transactions if any unregistered party transacts or supplies any goods or services to registered party. Since it's a unregistered one, he cannot charge any tax. But in that case, it will be duty of registered person to calculate tax on same and deposit the same. In this case, there will not be any duty of unregistered person to deposit any GST here, though the GST pertains to his transaction. Let's say, suppose it's a normal case of, suppose a normal case of rent, landlords are not registered as GST SSE, they simply tax rent. In that case, SSE will have to calculate GST and deposit same. In case of small supply, suppose you are taking tea and coffee for your office. Usually the small tea vendors, tea dealers are not registered. In that case, you will have to calculate GST and deposit them. Government has made this provision to charge tax on every item, either directly or indirectly. Let's say we are paying monthly rent, let's say 20,000. We are having tea supplies, let's say 3,000 more, and 23,000 are inward supplies that is liable to reverse charge. Friends, in case of reverse charge, if it is 9.4 item, then in that case it cannot be a interest transaction. Whereas if it is 9 subsection 3 transaction, it can be interested or intrastate. Since if the reason is that if any unregistered person supplies to registered party and that transaction is interstate, that means outside state, then that person will have to get himself registered with GST. Now move to next item is non-GST outward supplies. It means here only 3-4 items are non-GST item. Let's say petrol, diesel, liquor for human consumption. If you are supplying, then only you need to mention. If you are taking supply, then this is not appropriate block to mention. I punched confirm button. Friends, it's not accepting because I did not feed any tax here. Let's say it's entirely a state. I randomly punch any number. Okay friend, here you can see my IGST is 15,900, CGST 6,000, SGST 6,000. Now move on to next item, that is interstate supplies. Friends, here there are three blocks: supplies made to unregistered person, supplies made to composition taxable person, supplies made to UIN holder. The point that we need to remember here, that only we need to mention only interstate supplies here. If we are supplying intrastate to any unregistered person or composition dealer or UIN holder, we don't need to mention it here. Let's say we are supplying to unregistered party in case of Goa. Let's say taxable value is 3000, tax is, let's say, any number 300. Add here, it's quite simple, and you can select different states. Here you need to mention detail state wise. You can remove here, just simply click here and push a remove button. Next item is supplies made to composition taxable person. Composition taxable person means who have opted a composition scheme. Composition scheme, I will prepare separate video for same, what is composition scheme and all. Here you need to mention again same state wise thing. Let's say you have supplied to composition dealers in Haryana, say 4000, then punch a number of tax, then simply add button. It's quite simple. Then similarly UN bodies, I go back. If I would have confirmed it, this transaction would have been recorded here. Next item is eligible ITC. Yes, this is very important portion. Here details have been divided in A, B, C and D. A is deals with what is available in ITC, that is available to you in full or part. Part B deals with ITC reverse. Suppose you have taken any ITC, and because ITC is provided subject to certain conditions, and one of the condition is that if you have not paid for a particular transaction, then you will have to reverse that ITC here. There are various other conditions as well in which you can, you may have to reverse the ITC, rather provide the benefit back to the government. ITC C is net value, that is A, and B adjusted value, A minus B, and D is ineligible ITC. That means here you need to disclose it. This item is not going for any kind of calculation in point D, just mention here. Let's say import of goods. If your inward supply is pertaining to any import, then you must have paid IGST on here. Here you don't need to mention taxable value, just punch the tax amount for which credit is needed. Similarly, import of service, let's say 1000 rupees. Third item, very important, inward supplies liable to reversal other than 1 and 2 euro. That means here you need to be very careful here. Whatsoever item you have mentioned here, you need to exclude that item here. I have already told you about what is reverse charge and all in brief. So you need to mention here reverse charge supplies. Next item is inward supplies from ISD, that means input service distributor. In case of ISD, ISD does not do any kind of business. It just takes and distributes the credit. In case of big organization, this concept is very much prevalent. In case of a smaller organization, this concept has not much value. If you are taking any credit from ISD, because ISD is not doing any kind of transaction, it is just receiving and distributing credit. If any inward credit, if any you are taking any credit from ISD, then mention here as well. Then last item is all other ITC. Any other ITC which is not covered, mention here. Let's say 100 rupees. Next item is ITC reverse. Let's say you will have to reverse 3000. You had earlier taken it, now you will have to give it back to government. Net value is coming 3000. Let's say if change this value to 4000, changing it. Yes, you can clearly see that net ITC available is 2000 rupees. Last item is D part, that is ineligible ITC. Friends, we must read section 17 subsection 5 very very carefully, because 17 subsection 5 deals with transaction, rather credits that are not available to us. Suppose if you are, that means you cannot take any credit in case of any conveyance, and various other items are mentioned here. Suppose you are taking any kind of beauty treatment and tax had been levied here, then you cannot take credit here. If you have taken any membership, then you cannot take credit on tax paid on that membership, and various other items are there. Suppose you are taking food supplies for your office, your staff is taking snacks, and some tax must have been levied on that, then you cannot take the credit of same. So total 12 categories are there. So we will understand this thing in separate video. So 17.5, just read it carefully and don't take any credit. Here government is asking for disclosure purpose, so we need to be very careful. If you confirm here, you can easily save your data there. Next item is exempt nil rated and non GST inward supply. In the first portion we had seen outward supplies. Here we will see if we are taking any supplies from composition dealer, exempt dealer, or rather nil rated supplier, then we need to mention it here. Let's say we are taking any supply from composition scheme, inward scheme, then we need to mention it here. Similarly, interested supply. Then next item is non-GST supply. Non-GST supplies, as already explained, that petrol, diesel, liquor are in this list. If you are taking any supply of these items, then you need to mention here. Earlier, outward supply, in this transaction, inward supply. If you confirm here, your data will be saved. I have put cancel button. Next is interest and late fees. Friends, late fees, currently there is no late fees. Currently there is no late fee, that's why you can clearly see that this field is disabled. That means for if you are submitting your returns little late as of now, then your late fees have been waived by government. But there can be case of interest, because government has not exempted provided any notification for late payment of interest. Due date is 20th of the following month. If you are have made any kind of delay, then mention relevant interest here in case it pertains to IGST, CGST or SGST. Current rate is 18% per annum. You need to calculate on daily basis. That means you need to calculate on daily basis as well as your tax after due date. You need to calculate here and punch it accordingly. Then put a save button. After filling all this data, if you save this thing, let's say I save in GSTR 3B. I have saved it, friends, here. It's saying GSTR 3B is saved successfully. Now, the moment I preview and submit it, this field, that is payment of tax field, will get enabled, and I can pay my applicable GST duty here. But before that, I cannot click it here. I need to first preview and submit it, then only we can pay our duty from here. That's not a difficult step, that's quite easy step. I am not doing it, because if I submit it, then this GST return will be wrong. This GST return only for purpose of this video only. If I go back, then I will go back on my dashboard. Simply, friends, I hope you will like that video. Whatsoever your feedback, comments, queries, please post on in comments box, and do subscribe our channel. Thank you friends for watching this video.